The sky is not the limit, increasing our capacity to believe. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Isaiah 55, 8 and 9. When I was a kid, one of my favorite things to do was to camp out under the stars with my cousins. I didn't want to sleep in a tent because I loved looking at the stars, and I still love looking at them today. When I look up at the twinkling stars in the night sky, I can't help but be amazed at the expansive universe that stretches out far beyond the ability of the human eye to see. I know that I'm not alone in wonder and awe, for I'm sure that countless generations throughout history have also looked up, seeking to understand the vastness of the starry cosmos. Our solar system is just a pinpoint in the Milky Way galaxy, which is a cosmic ocean dotted with an estimated 400 billion stars, and the universe beyond sparkles with billions more galaxies. Truly, the heavens do declare the glory of God, and the firmament does show His handiwork. To show the majesty of God, the prophet Isaiah gives us a glimpse of who God is in comparison with who we are. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Isaiah 55, verse 9. But just how far are the heavens above the earth? Have you ever stopped to think about it? While God's power cannot be measured by human standards, let's pause here a moment. As we know, the basic unit of measurement in the universe is a light year. To understand the significance of a light year, let's do some simple mathematical calculation. Scientific research has shown that light travels at an amazing speed of 186,000 miles per second, which, according to NASA, is so fast that in the time it takes to snap your fingers, light can circle the Earth over 7 times. That's pretty fast, but we are just getting started. In 1 minute, light travels a little over 11 million miles. If we multiply that by 1,440, the number of minutes in 24 hours, we find that in 1 day, light will travel a little over 16 billion miles. If we multiply this by 365 days, we find that in a year, light travels a whopping 5.9 trillion miles, and that, dear friends, is just one light year. According to scientific calculations, the outer edge of the observable universe is estimated at 46 to 47 billion light years away, a distance so vast that we can't even begin to comprehend it. But even the best human calculations don't come close to accurately measuring God's expansive universe, much less His immeasurably vast love. Inspiration tells us, the mightiest intellects of earth cannot comprehend God. Men may be ever searching, ever learning, and still there is an infinity beyond. When Abraham began his journey of faith, not knowing where he was going and questioning whether he would ever have a son, God took him outside his tent one night and asked him if he could number the stars. Look now toward heaven, and tell the stars if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. Genesis 15, 5. Abraham could only shake his head in awe and wonder, just as we do today. And yet the Bible tells us that God not only knows the number of the stars, He also calls them all by name. Psalms 147, verse 4. While Abraham couldn't comprehend God's promise, he believed His word. As a result, therefore sprang there even of one, and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the seashore innumerable. Hebrews 11, 12. Amazingly, God is still fulfilling His promise to Abraham today. As we begin to understand the magnificent God we serve, we might echo the cry of King David. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? Psalms chapter 8, verses 3 and 4. Hard as it is to comprehend, Our God, who stretched out the heavens by His great power, is mindful of us. He is not only mindful, but He has also created us and commissioned us with a holy calling. We are to be co-laborers with Him. We are to be a light to the Gentiles, to open the eyes of the blind, and to set free those locked in darkness. Isaiah 42 verses 5 to 7. Nothing honors God quite as much as when we have faith for the completion of His work. Faith that sees far beyond our own ability and grasps His infinite resources, for we are told that nothing is too hard for Him. Jeremiah 32 verse 17. Inspiration assures us the power at God's command is limitless. Limitless? Do we comprehend what this means? When it comes to God, the sky is not the limit. The universe is not the limit. There are no limits except for the limit of our faith. We have too little faith. We limit the Holy One of Israel. We should be grateful that God condescends to use any of us as His instruments. For every earnest prayer put up in faith for anything, answers will be returned. They may not come just as we have expected, but they will come. Not perhaps as we have desired, but at the very time when we most need them. If we truly realized how big our God is, we would have a lot more faith to move forward in His work. We would also have a lot more faith when we pray. Let me share the testimony of a humble man named Golden. This ongoing modern-day miracle story has inspired and challenged me as no other.